जस्ट शेयर माई स्क्रीन। आई होप माई स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। नाउ हियर वन कैन सी RI386 4.0.5 वर्जन दैट इज इंस्टॉल्ड ऑन माई डेस्कटॉप। इट्स शॉर्टकट इज क्रिएटेड एंड बिलो दैट RX64.0.5 इज ऑल्सो इंस्टॉल्ड। So both for 32 bit and for 64 bit, both icons will get create. So how to detect, first of all, whether the R is installed or not. So first we install R and then R Studio on Windows, say for example. So this is Windows 10 operating system I'm using on my desktop. So in the search bar, you may type R Studio and you can see here the R Studio app is already installed. Like that you should get it after installation. So once it is confirmed that the RStudio is visible over here, when you type RStudio in your search box, then it is confirmed that RStudio is installed on your device completely. Now if you have to see whether it is running or working properly or not, I will just tell you later how to see that. So I think I should first of all tell you how to start the installations of R and R Studio on Windows 10. For other operating systems, I will share the link how to install, including on Windows 10 and Mac OS, all other operating systems. I will just share the link in the description box of this video. So let me just write few things, few steps on the whiteboard. So I hope this whiteboard is visible. Now on this whiteboard, I will just write few steps in short for installations. So how to install R and R Studio on Windows 10. So for that you will need two things. Of course your device and the internet connection you have to check. So in internet Firefox, suppose you go, then you have to go to this site www.r-project.org, then you go to the tab namely getting started on this homepage of R. So this gives you homepage of R. Okay, so on that homepage of R, you have to go to get started. Then you have to click on the tab download R. Okay, now on CRAN mirror page. So you can see this terminology on that page when you start or click on download R. So we'll get directed to this page on CRAN mirror page under OCloud. Click on the link. Which link? So that link I am just writing over here. So you have to click on the link HTTPS that is visible over there. If you just go on following these steps, you will understand. cloud.rproject.org, and there again you can see this download R for Windows tab, and then you have to just install R for the first time. You have to click on that tab and then download Windows. Download R. I'm going to next page. Download R. The version is 3.6.1 for Windows. There you have to click and then you have to save the file. Okay, So these are the steps to install. So once you click on save the files, the download will start. Okay. So here after this step, the download starts. Then you have to open downloaded exe file, executable file from downloads. So on your device, you have to go to downloads and you have to open the downloaded executable file for R. Then you have to follow instructions. You have to click on next, next, next. You have to follow instructions. And lastly, you have to say install and finish. Okay. So the desktop shortcut will get create on your device. Okay. So there are two different icons. Just now, before few time, I showed you two different icons will appear on your desktop for 32-bit and for 64-bit. So right now, my device is Windows 10 operating system with 64-bit. So I will open that 64-bit icon. So you have two options now. Okay. So this is installation of R. So once you install R, okay, so these are the instructions just I showed you. You will get two icons here. You can see you will get two icons. Let me just take this icon, two icons, one for 32-bit and one for 64-bit. So right now my operating system is 64-bit. So using command line, you may perform. So this is R software. After following, just now I told you the steps. After following those steps, R will get installed on your device and with these two shortcuts. So of course you have to click on create shortcuts while installing. Don't forget. My operating system is 64-bit. So I will open the second shortcut that is created on my device. Okay. Now I will just check whether this R is installed on my device completely and correctly or not. What I will do, I will just open the 64-bit R that is installed on my device. So let me just double click on this. So this kind of window will get display. Now I have to check whether this R is doing the calculations and operations correctly or not. So you have to type some operations. Say for example, suppose I type exp. So here you can see red arrow. So I have typed exp inside a round bracket. I will type 1, exponential of 1 or e raised to 1. And if I just enter, it is giving me the correct value of that exponential irrational number e having value 2.718282. Okay. And this confirms us that R is installed on our device correctly. Okay. So just for the confirmation, I have done this. Suppose you have to quit this window of R. You may type Q and just empty round bracket and just press enter. So if I do this Q empty round bracket and if I press enter, it will ask you to save this workspace image or not. So it's for whatever commands you are writing on R editor. So this is R editor window. So right now I have just typed one command, exp of 1, and it is giving me the correct answer. So it is installed correctly. It's just for confirmation I'm doing. So it will ask you whether you have to save the workspace image or not. I will just say no because it is of no use. But suppose you are using or writing some important commands hereafter, as we go deeper and deeper in R, you will understand. So in that case, you have to save the images for your future study. Suppose you have to refer in future. You may not remember all the commands. So that's the use. Okay. So right now I will say just no, because it's not having just, it is not having much useful things right now. Yeah. So now I'm again in on my own whiteboard. Now I will, so these steps are for installation of R. Now I will tell you how to install R Studio on your device. Okay. So now installing R Studio. So R Studio is, you may use R itself just to do the operations, whatever you want to do. But RStudio is user-friendly apparatus which is used instead of R. So I am more comfortable with RStudio. In RStudio, you are having four different windows. I will tell you after the installation as we proceed in the lecture. So first of all, you have to go to this site, www.rstudio.com. Then you have to click on download RStudio button over there. You just follow these steps. So you will understand. It's very simple. So you have to click on this button. Then you have to locate RStudio desktop. So this is first step, I can say. This is second step. Third step is locate RStudio desktop open source license free. And you have to click on download. Okay. And then you may have older versions of RStudio. You have to install RStudio desktop. .1.1.463. Then you have to go to Windows installer zip. Then you have to save file. Again, whatever we have done while installing R, you have to save the file. Okay, that is the executable file from where you can install RStudio. So executable file will open. Then you have to download. Okay. And then you have to go to downloads folder on your device. And then you have to click on that executable file, double click, of course. Then you have to double click on executable file, .exe file, and follow instructions and install. You have to just say next. So you have to follow all the instructions, tick mark. Okay. I agree terms and conditions, like that instructions are there, and install. So these are the steps. So now once the installation is complete, okay. So this is how to install RStudio. So I have told you the steps to install R and RStudio. Now let me just show you, because I have already installed it on my device. So you have to go to search bar. I have already shown you. I'm again showing you. So here in the search tab in the bottom, okay, here, let me just take, yeah, here, this is the search bar. So here you have to just type RStudio. Now here one can see the apparatus is installed on your device. So let me just go over there. If I click on RStudio, you will get this kind of interface of RStudio. So one can observe here that this particular RStudio has four different windows. Okay, this is script window, that is left hand top window. Okay, this is console. Okay, below that, the window, it is over there, that is console. This is workspace, where you will get all the information of whatever variables you are defining, whatever data frames you are opening, like that. So this is workspace. And this is file and plots window, where you will get the pictorial representation of the data that you are trying to display. Okay. So this is RStudio interface. So it's very user friendly and what you can say, handy. So suppose you have to check whether the installation of RStudio is complete and it is completely installed or not, or is it is running commands or not. What you have to do is just go to console window. Okay, so here it is the bottom left hand window where you have this blue arrow and the cursor is. I suppose I click over there, the cursor will blink. So over there I will go, and here I will just type some command. Say for example, one of the command that I'm using right now is plot command. And suppose I have to plot the numbers from 1 to 5 versus 1 to 5. Suppose I control enter this particular command, this command will run. And now you can see in this right bottom window, which is called as files and plot window, there you will get the graph of the number 1 versus 1 is getting plotted, 2 versus 2. So 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 3 comma 3, 4 comma 4, and 5 comma 5. So these 5 points will get plot, taking x-axis as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and y-axis as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, with some scale by default. So this means that RStudio is completely installed on my device. Okay. Now there is so here one can see that this arrow is coming. So these are the four windows. But suppose I'm right now not using the script window. First window is script window where right now the cursor is blinking. First left-hand side top window is called as the script window that I'm not using right now. So I can minimize it like this. Okay. And suppose you are completely working in console. So you may work in script file that I have minimized. You may maximize it again. Okay. You may minimize it like that. You can do it. But right now I wish to work in a console window, but lots of things by default will come like this. Just to avoid the chaos, I just want to remove everything on console window, whatever information by default it is giving you. Here are some commands it is giving you, like type QR, Q, empty open bracket to quit R, like that. Help, empty bracket. Here you can read out all these things if you want it. Demo, empty bracket for some demos, like that. But suppose I have to remove everything and I have to start freshly, I will just type Control L to clear everything on the console window. Okay, so this is how to I mean do it. Okay, so this is console window. Here I will click, so the cursor will blink. Now we have to install some packages which are useful in statistical calculations, namely PLYR package, MASS, capital MASS, and ggplot2. Okay, so ggplot2 is used in graphical representations like probability histogram, bar chart, subdivided bar diagram, pie chart, etc. And you can enhance the pictorial representation of statistical data using these packages. Okay, so it is having advanced commands, so therefore the packages are useful. So let me just tell you how to install these important packages. First package we will install is PLYR package. I think I have already installed it, but no problem. I can do it again just to demonstrate. In the console window, so this is your console window. So in the console window, what you do is, so I have minimized the first window, namely script window, and I am in console window right now. So here I will write the command install dot packages. So it is coming by default, you can see. Okay, below this. So once I start typing a particular command, now this command is for installing packages. So I will just click and I will enter. So if I click on enter, or if I just click on that particular command that is coming by default, the cursor will blink inside the empty round bracket. And there we have to write the name of the package that we want to install. Say, for example, suppose I have to install first package, namely PLYR package. I will just like write PLYR inside the double colon, inside that empty round bracket. and I will just say control enter. Once I say control enter, some warnings will come, and the red line warnings, those things, it doesn't mean that something is going wrong. It means that the package PLIVR is installing on your device on inside your RStudio, and after that the package PLIVR successfully unpacked and it is installed on your RStudio. Like that the instruction will come. So it means that PLIVR package is installed on your device, and you can use the advanced commands that are inbuilt inside this package. We will see later what are the commands in PLIVR package, why it is used. MASS is another such a package that I can also install using the same command, install dot packages, and then inside that, inside double colon, you have to just type MASS, enter, okay, and then it will say that the package MASS is successfully unpacked, means installed. Then ggplot2 is the third package that I'm installing. So install packages command I will use. Inside double colon, I will just type the name of the package that I wish to install, ggplot2 package. Just press enter. It will also get installed. Okay, it is successfully unplugged and installed. And the last one is dplyr package. So I will just again type the command install packages, and inside the double colon I will plot dplyr, okay, and I will just press enter, and this also will get installed. Okay, similarly you can install any other package if you want, depending upon your need. Right now we are interested in doing statistical calculations, so these are the four packages just now I told you, namely PLYR package, MASS, ggplot2, and dplyr package. Okay, press control L to clear everything. So if I press control L, it will clear everything on your console window with whatever you have installed. So packages are, once it is installed, you may use in future window. Here on files and plot command, that particular graph is still displayed. Suppose I have to just clear that also, you can click on this broom icon in files and plot window, and you can remove it. It will ask you to, are you sure to clear all the plots in the history? So we'll say yes, because I just want to remove everything. Now everything is now again clear. Okay, yeah, so now we'll start with some basic commands in R. Like basically, R is how R can be used as a calculator. That is our first topic, which will give us the basic commands in R. There are some built-in functions in R, like sine function, cosine function, cos, sine, cos, log. Then you can do vector operations. You can multiply two vectors. You can add two vectors, subtracting two vectors, like that. Then we may plot few things in R, and you may take help in RStudio also. Suppose you don't know any particular command for a particular operation you wish to do, you may take help command. You may take help of help command in R, and you may proceed. Okay, so yeah. So suppose I wish to multiply two numbers. Say for example, suppose I have to multiply 2.3 and say 7.8 or 8, whatever. So I will just make star 7.8, and I will just control enter or just enter. It will display the answer. 2.3 into 7.8 is 17.94. Okay, so suppose I press upper arrow. Suppose I press up arrow. Then it will again display the same command, pressing up arrow key. So which up arrow? I'm telling you, this up arrow. Suppose you press this key on your keyboard inside RStudio console, you will get the same statement that you have tried previously in your console. So you'll get same statement again. So let me just go to RStudio again. Yeah, so here in the console window, suppose I will just press enter. Okay, it will again show you the same answer. Suppose I just press that up arrow key on my keyboard. Again, it will display the same previous command that you have typed. Yeah, that is okay. Then suppose I have to add two numbers. Say for example, suppose I have to add 56 plus 78. If I press enter or control enter, it will show you the answer. It's such an easy task. After that, suppose I have to give name to a particular statement. Say for example, I'm calling A as 56 plus 78. So how will you define 134 or whatever, 56 plus 78 as that A? So what you do, just give the name, a variable name, or you may say a constant. 56 plus 78 is equal to A. So you just use this hyphen dash and then write that 56 plus 78 in front of that. Okay, and suppose I enter, it means that 56 plus 78, whatever is the answer, we know the answer, 134, we call him it as A hereafter. Okay, so I'm defining A as 134 or A as 56 plus 78. Now here in this environment window, which is right hand side top window, once I run this command, you will get the variable names or the constant A, you are calling it as say 134, that will get display. Okay, so hereafter, whatever variable names or constant names I'm using in the console window, that will get display in this environment window. Okay, so one can see A is 134 that you already defined. So hereafter in the calculations, the variable A will take the value 134. Or the other way of defining, like defining that constant, is suppose simply A is equal to 56 plus 78. Like that also you can do. If I press enter, again, it means the same thing. A is defined like that. Okay. Now suppose on the next line in the console, if I just press A and if I say enter, it will show you what value A is taking. So value A is taking 134 is the value that your variable name A is taking. Okay. So addition, subtraction, raising to a power, square root of a number, exponential of any number, or logarithmic of exponential of one, like that you can try. I mean, say 56 minus 78 may do. It will give you the answer. Or suppose I want to take a square root of some number. Suppose I have to take square root of A. Okay, so I will just write SQRT inside a round bracket. I will write A. Now it will take 134 and it will display its square root. Suppose I press enter. The square root of 134 is 11.575584, like that. Okay, so after that, exponential of 1, I should get 2.718 something. So these are the basic calculative commands. Suppose I have to find out a log of, say, exponential of 1. Expected answer is 1 because logarithm and exponential are inverse functions of each other. So like that we will proceed. Okay. Suppose I have to take log of 10 raised to 5 to the base 10. So suppose the base is not e, logarithmic base is not e, but the logarithmic base is to the base 10, then we'll just write log 10. Here the command is coming. Okay. So log to the base 10 of, say, 10 raised to 7. Suppose I press enter, I will get 7 as the answer. That's quite obvious. Or the same thing, suppose I have to find out log of 10 raised to 7 to the base 10. We may type it like that. Say, using log function inside a round bracket, I will write 10 raised to 7 comma 10. So it means that you are finding log of 10 raised to 7 to the base 10. If I press enter, I will get the same answer again. So last two commands, log 10 inside a round bracket 10 raised to 7, and the second log 10 raised to 7 comma 10, one and the same. So these two commands are finding log to the base 10 of whatever number you are taking. So these are the two ways to get log to the base 10 of a particular number. Okay. Yeah. So then suppose I have to define a sequence. So let me just clear this window because we are going to the bottom of the page of the console. So let me just clear with Control L I'm pressing. So Control L for clearing the console window. Yes. So now I'm going to define a sequence using SEQ command. Okay, whose lower limit is say minus 10, upper limit is say 5, with increment say 0.5. Okay, so suppose I name that sequence with some letter, say suppose S is the sequence, okay, which is equal to, so let me not use S, otherwise it's confusing. Suppose it's a sequence defined by say any letter, say H. So H is the sequence, SEQ is the command. Like that you can see, once you go on typing SEQ, the command list already is coming by default. Out of that I just want SEQ, so I may select it. So if I select whatever is coming inside the list of table, the round empty bracket will appear. So in this round empty bracket you have to give the lower limit of your sequence, the upper limit of your sequence, and whatever increment you want to take. Okay, so suppose I want to start my sequence from minus 10. So this is the lower limit of your sequence, comma, the upper limit of my sequence is say 6, up to 6, or let us take 10. Okay, from minus 10 to 10 my sequence goes with increment 0.5. Okay, so first number is lower limit of your sequence, upper limit of your sequence is 10, and with increments 0.5 you are going. Suppose I press Control Enter, then you can see in this environment window H is number. So how many numbers you will get in this sequence? 41 numbers, from 1 to 41. From minus 10, here the sequence is getting displayed, you can see. But if suppose I keep this arrow on this particular row, then numbers from minus 10, minus 9.5, minus 9, minus 8.5, minus 8, like that. It will go till 10. And there are 40. How many? From 1 to 41, 41 numbers. Okay, now suppose I have to find out length of the sequence. The length is the command, L-E-N-G-T-H. So length command will appear. I will just press enter and I will just want to find out length of the sequence H. If I press enter, it's 41. Okay, that can be displayed on environment window. So here just now we have seen. Yeah, so length is 41. So this is how to define a sequence. Now PI, pi, its value, you know, 3.14, like that. Okay. Yeah, so suppose I have to define a sequence, which I'm calling it as X. So X is a sequence which is running from, say, minus 2 pi, comma, up to 2 pi with increment 1. From minus 2 pi to 2 pi, your sequence goes. So suppose I press enter. Yeah, so what's the error? Error is that minus 2 should multiply with pi. So I have to put the star. Suppose I press up arrow key. What's my error is I have not typed star in between of minus 2 pi and pi. So like that it will go. If I press enter now, it will come. Now you can see in environment window, you have 13. So your sequence is of length 13. Starting from minus 6.28, which is minus 2 pi, up to 6.28, which is 6, which is 2 pi. Okay, and suppose the another sequence Y, I'm calling it as, is sine of that X. So I'm using by default function, sine function, that is the inbuilt function in RStudio, of X. Whatever are the values in the sequence X, their sine values you calculate, call those sine values as say Y. This is how the command we have given to RStudio. So again, you know, length of X and length of Y will be same, because Y is calculated from the sequence X. Suppose I press enter, you can see in the environment window, X is also of length 13 and Y is also of length 13. X are your domain values from minus 2 pi to 2 pi, and Y are your function values corresponding to those values in the domain. And now suppose I wish to plot X versus Y. So X is the sequence from minus 2 pi to 2 pi with increment 1, and Y is the sequence of sine values of those domain values. Then I will just simply use the plot function, okay, of X comma Y. So I have to plot X versus Y. So I will just write X comma Y inside a plot function, and I will write type is equal to double colon. You have to type L. I will just tell you later what does it mean, type is equal to L. It's actually a type of the plot. We will go in deeper and deeper with respect to this type command inside a plot after some lectures. So suppose I press enter, you may see in file and plot window, which is the right hand side bottom window, the sine wave is getting plotted from minus 2 pi to 2 pi, namely from minus 6.28 to 6.28. So with this, I will just close my lecture one on R. So I will just give you some books on R. Say, I will just write some books and their names. So some good books on R are Learning. The first book is Learning R Studio for R, Statistical Computing by Mark P. Z. Van der Loo, Edwin Day, John J., June 2013. Second book is R Graphics Cookbook by Winston Chang, 2012. And third is R in a Nutshell by Joseph Elder, second edition, October 2012. Yeah, so these are some good books. So you may use. With this, I will close my lecture. Thank you.